Hey, BJ, don't worry. I'll plant the wheat. Brother, do I let him go first and open the gate? I guess I'll be a nice guy. Somebody cut our privacy fence. Morning, Squishy. Go round up some cameras before we get going. Might as well pull this thing out of here. BJ, congratulations on conquering your fear of heights. Now it is just a little bit after 8 o'clock. Had quite a bit of dew. We'll probably get started here pretty soon, but I'm gonna wait for just a little bit. Got a couple trucks to unload and a few other little things to do this morning while we're waiting on this dew to kind of burn off. And then we only have 5 acres left in this field. That'll be one load, but we should have some dry corn right over there, about 30 acres over there. My drive-thru sure is dirty. That won't do. We're getting ready to load our dryer for the first time. Thought we were all ready to go. And then I looked in this inspection plate and found this rotten stuff. So trying to vacuum it out because we don't want that going into our dryer. Never done. So this morning we are using our AGI system for the first time. We actually just got our first 3D model on our phones. Pull mine up here. This is the first time we use this, so we're still kind of getting the hang of it. See, we have grain here. Our moisture sensors are saying 19.20 and 19.3. I was testing that grain anywhere from 19 to 20%, so that seems about right. Go to our 3D view here. Here you can see about the levels of the grain. You can move this around. Kind of play with that some. Now with this being our holding bin, we are going to not put this fan on automatic. We are going to just basically run the fan all the time just because corn is going to be going in and out and in and out. But once we get this bin filled for the very last time, we will switch it to automatic and AGI is going to be running our fans for us based on what temperature and what moisture we want that corn to be when we pull it out. Pretty excited about this system. Hopefully everything works like we're thinking it's going to. That's why we're gonna put beans in one of these far bins. That's what we're really excited to see how it works in that. But I guess I can kind of see how full my wet bin is now. Now, if you guys are interested in the AGI system, we are not sponsored by AGI, but we do have a landing page on AGI's website. And if you use the code Brian, you get a free trial version of their software, a link in the description. But now we gotta go fishing. You got the fishing line? Here, I'll show you what I mean when I say we gotta go fishing. We're loading the dryer, and that corn coming out of the dryer is going into this bin. All right, somehow we gotta tie these cables to the floor. Now this bin had corn in it whenever they installed the cables, so they didn't tie them to the floor for us. In the other bins, they used a self-tapper drilled into the floor, and that self-tapper had an eyelet on the flush with the ground, and that's what they tied them to. Did you get it fed through there? I'll be darned.
Not as bad as you thought.
They're off. Hot dang. Larry's walking down to get that truck. Dad's got one more pass. Only thing is, it's about a mile. So it's going to take a little bit. There's a good corn.
Yeah, it's good corn. I'm off. I'm low, though.
Huh, well, good. How you liking combining a 16-row planter?
Well, where that guy planted grows and accurate, they mad.
Looks like we might have a problem there.
Yeah.
Might be a little bit of a bulk route. Put a cap corn. Dad's combine just got a little hot. One thing that the newer Claas combines do, they have a different kind of cooling system, but sometimes the screen will stick and the fan won't rotate. I'd say when that rain last night, we got just enough moisture on it that when it dried, it prevented the fan from turning, so
easy fix. Go up here and fix that real fast. Oh yeah. Now we're good. That's what happened. A little bit of chaff with these wings that got up there. And then when they got wet, they kind of made it stick.
That yield map just proves you can't grow anything in the shade. That's where the red's at. That's the end of that one. Just finishing eating lunch, noticed a couple semis pulling in. That aren't ours.
Oh, good God. Hi, baby, mommy freeze you? You cold?
Well, would you looky there. I guess now we have three 1038s and an air seater.
What do you mean you don't want it?
Huh?
What do you mean you don't
want it? Yeah, I'll take it. Big Mama came over to see us. She stole my wheels again. We'll have to get her a pink rock saw.
Do I look like a pink kind of person?
It's true. Black, just like your heart. And Dad's just starting this field. We're cruising the baby to sleep, waiting on a truckload that Larry's now.
Looks like Brian's watching me, or Kaylee is. Give me a different camera. I don't know any better sound. Find out. Starting another field here called the Log Yard. One that had pine trees in it. We cleaned up a couple years ago. Kind of rough. Pretty good corn. Just looking. Top broke out. But it's good corn.
Uh oh. I see a combine parked with the side panels up. That's probably not good. So we got a broken belt. It is not a belt that we have with us, but Ohio Ag does have one. That's our dealer. So one of us is gonna be making a parts run. We gotta get the old belt off of the combine. Yeah, we gotta get this off of here. Pretty sure we're gonna have to pull this pulley off to do that. Then it probably won't be that bad of a swap. We just got on the phone with Ohio Ag, the service advisor there. He kind of helped tell us really how to take this apart the easiest way. So we're gonna run this variable speed pulley out. He says if we do that, we get enough slop in this rib belt to take it off. Then we won't have to remove one of these pulleys. And that'll make this job a little bit easier. It's always nice when you have a good service department. Because no matter what brand you got, at some point you're gonna need the service department. Unless you hit enough Powerball numbers, then you just trade them off. Broke a belt, trade it off. Time for an oil change, trade her off. Grease, trade her off.
It's coming out, loosen that belt up. Hopefully we can get it off there now.
While they're getting that belt off there, just so happens that Dad happened to have a spare belt for another part of the combine. Same belt number. So we got a belt. Should be a fairly quick fix. I'm going to get the Thundercreek. Dad says he's a little low on fuel. Might as well do that while we are fixing the belt. Boy, you guys are in luck. A new demo unit shows up and you get a George siding all in one day.
You're just in time to fix the combine. Broke belt.
Now I'm going to get the fuel trailer. You'll never believe it, but he had a spare belt. Complete accident. Best part about this trailer. And we missed. Yeah, get a little bit of thunder juice in her. And I guess they got the belt already back on. Is it on?
Yep.
About an hour of downtime, plus we get a fuel up. Not bad.
Yeah, we had a breakdown. I had a fan belt on the separator rope. A very big belt. About an hour, got it gone. We had one, I didn't know I had. And, so we're back to business. Yellow point.
Well, Larry's taking the truck back down. And we're going to stay on board for today. We were originally going to switch to beans, but there's clouds coming in, there's pop-up showers all around us. So we're just going to try to get these acres of corn right here by the bins harvested. Dax, what happened to your hair, dude?
The helmet made it lazy.
Were you riding your razor in the yard?
Yeah.
Yeah? Did you make a racetrack?
Yep.
Oh, that face says he might have done a donut or two.
He went through the mud.
You a little guilty there, son? Yeah. Alright, Larry went on home with me, Dad, and BJ. And of course, I got the little dude helping me. He's quite the sweeping man. Now, if I'd known the weather was going to be like this, I probably just would have went ahead and brought my combine over and switched it to do corn. We were kind of thinking we were going to run beans with it this afternoon, but with all these pop-up showers, like I said, we just decided to focus on corn. You ready to get in the truck?
Yeah.
Alright, you drive.
I'm kidding, I'm kidding.
Need help?
Yeah.
All right, come on. Man, it's trying to rain. I don't know if you can see the raindrops, but we're still able to keep going. As long as it'll keep feeding into the head, it's going to take a long time before the field gets too sloppy to move. Biggest problem is going to be if the fodder quits feeding into the combine very well. Apparently, there's a pot of gold over there in that cornfield. Huh. Must not be worth much. Man, that is a really good rainbow. Kind of a double rainbow. Huh. Kayla just brought dinner, so I guess we're stopping to eat. Sun came back out though. Ooh. I think I see where one of the kids sat.
Oh, that was your seat.
Where is it, bud?
Is there any other way to eat pumpkin pie?
Alright,
back to work. Temperature's dropping. Supposed to get a little chilly tonight. Feels like fall. Yep, there's my blast house. Story time. This land used to have a bomb manufacturing plant on it for the U.S. Navy. And that's one of the buildings they used to assemble bombs in. It's basically just a very thick concrete structure with little 4-foot by 4-foot rooms. And apparently them rooms, that's where they built the bombs. It is so thick and full of rebar, we can't get rid of it. That is where it stays. Tried. Well, about had a row of shame. BJ, your windows are dirty.
Yes. Thanks for pointing that out.
You're welcome. Have fun.
We'll do. I'm gonna finish this field and we're gonna go start another little field over 5-6 acre field over here, see if we can do that tonight. Starting to get a little dark.
BJ's putting fields in the U harvest system. That's unprefers scale system. This is a different cart than we had last year. It has a different computer on the cart. That's what the fields and everything would be stored in, so we got an intermit. Yeah, we're just sitting here. Dad's doing this 6-acre field. It's real windy. It's kind of an odd-shaped field. In fact, there it is. So really, we're just sitting here. And it just dawned on me, this is Brother BJ's 1-year anniversary of being a full-time farmer.
Holy crap, it is.
Yeah,
it
is. October 1st.
October 1.
I was going to get you a little Debbie cake and put a candle in it, and I completely forgot.
I'm totally disappointed now.
You got a piece of pumpkin pie.
I did. It was good. It was good.
So, happy anniversary.
Thanks. Look at that crooked parking job.
Yeah, I did that to challenge you.
Keeping your skills up.
Guess that's a wrap for today. All right, we got some stuff to put up. I had to run over to their farm, close up the drive through over there, put the combine up that's over there. This air seeder and this tractor, we will go over that in the near future, I promise. We are going to be planting some wheat with that. That is a sunflower 30-foot air drill. I don't know a whole lot about how it works, to be honest with you. Our AgCo rep, Derek, he was the one that was down here with the Fit Momentum planter. He's going to be coming down next week after we cut some bean acres. We will be running that thing next week. Throwing some wheat in the ground. Now they did bring a 1038. That is not our 1038. It's a little bit different, different size tires, but other than that, very similar. Pretty excited to use that thing, but like I said, it's gonna be next week. All right, my combine's been sitting here out because we thought we were gonna do beans today, like I said. So I'm gonna put it up because we're obviously not doing beans tonight. Tomorrow, hopefully. But I don't like leaving it sit out, especially when there's an empty building right there. Definitely not how I thought I'd see the combine lights for the first time this year. Hey, I'm putting her in the middle this time. I'm the only combine here. No need to get over there in the corner all by myself. Nope, we're taking up the middle of the barn. Look at that little 4020 over there. Ain't it cute? All right, guys, that's gonna be it for this video. If you like what you've seen, don't forget to thumbs up the video. Like I said a few videos back, trying to get that to where we're at 10,000 a video. So let's see if we can get that done. If you need any Brown Farms merch or Brian's Farm Videos merch, check the link in the description and we'll see you in the next one.